Member Nelson Creston.
Madam Speaker, like the hundreds of thousands of people around British Columbia, the Mission Association for Community Living is concerned about this government's bus pass clawback for people with disabilities. They are asking for this decision to be reversed, and I quote, BC disability rate is among the lowest in the country, yet we live in one of the most expensive provinces. They also noted, quote, to finally give people an increase only to claw it back for something as essential as transportation is mean-spirited and out of touch. So will the Minister of Social Development, if she's not going to listen to the hundreds of thousands of other British Columbians who are voicing their concern on this issue, will she at least listen to the Mission Association for Community Living and reverse her decision and this government's decision to implement the bus pass clawback?
Minister for Social Development and Social Innovation.
Well, thank you, Madam Speaker, and we can continue to canvass this subject again and again here in the House. The investment is a $170 million investment to raise the rates and provide transportation to 100,000 people who receive disability assistance in this province. Government recognized there was an inequity in the system with 45,000 people not receiving supports for transportation. By making this change, people still have the transportation subsidy. They also have the money to pay for the subsidy. And Madam Speaker, now the system is fair.
Member Nelson Creston on a supplemental.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Well, the Minister's been on this line of spin for about a month, and in this spin line, she's been accusing people with disabilities and their advocates
members
of misrepresenting the information, when in fact they are the very people.
Members, this House will come to order. Minister. Please continue.
Madam Speaker, the best people to deliver the facts on this issue are the very people who are going to be living the results of these changes. People with disabilities, they are the best people to communicate what's going on. And in fact, if anybody... Madam Speaker, in fact, if anybody has been misrepresenting what's been going on, the minister has, with falsely representing the position of an advocate in this very question period. Following the exchange, BC Acorn had to publicly correct the minister, saying that their quote was taken out of context and not accurate. BC Acorn also said, quote, Libs tried to make an insultingly tiny rate increase look better, and directly told the minister, quote, you know our members are furious. So again to the minister, stop with this spin. Just stop with it already. There's hundreds of thousands of people around this province who are concerned, who are angry, who want to see this government do the right thing. Will you do that and end the bus pass clawback? Stop giggling while you're at it.
Member for Nelson Creston knows it's never appropriate to impugn an improper motive. Minister of Social Development.
Madam Speaker, what's being taken out of context here are the facts. Madam Speaker, there is an increase. There still remains a subsidized bus pass. People still have transportation. They have choice on how they try to use that transportation. The communication here is the problem, and it needs to stop from the members opposite. They are causing anxiety and stress for people with disabilities around this province. Only the NDP, Madam Speaker, would see a $170 million investment as a cut. Yeah.